So, welcome students to this session wherein we will learn how to estimate the quantities of septic tank, okay, septic tank and then also soak pit. Okay, so in the previous class, I had explained what exactly is a septic tank and what is the role of a soak pit, manhole, all those things, general idea I had given you. So today we will learn how to exactly prepare a detailed estimate of this septic tank, okay, along with an abstract. So this is the problem that is given, okay, and all these quantities we have to work out. Okay, we can see that we have 9 quantities to work out, starting from earthwork, okay, earthwork, then foundation bed concrete, roof covering of the soak pit, then some brickwork which is there, right, walls, that quantity we need to calculate. After that, we need to calculate the plastering which is required, okay, inside plastering, okay, for the walls as well as the flooring. Then this is for flooring. Then there are certain pipes which are there for inlet and outlet that we need to consider. Then a vent pipe is there for letting out exhaust gases, that vent pipe. And then some steps are there which helps us to get into and get out of the soak pit. Okay, so all these quantities we have to estimate, and we can see that they have given also the rates. They have given us the rates. This will be helpful in preparing the abstract of your estimate. Okay, so these 9 quantities we need to calculate. So let me show you the longitudinal section. Okay, so this is the LS of your septic tank. Okay, so you can observe from the top. So this is your vent pipe for letting out your exhaust gases, right? Your gases. Then, so this is 2 meter high, okay, ventilation pipe. And this is your roof slab, okay, roof slab, which is starting from here, okay, starting from this this end, going up to this end. Okay, the thickness of the roof slab is 7.5 centimeters, thickness of roof slab. Then brickwork you can observe. So this is entire thing is your brickwork over here, okay. So this wall is made up of bricks. So it is made in 2 steps, okay. 2 steps you can observe. First, this step is a bit thinner, and this step, as we go below, it is becoming thicker. So it is a lot below step, it is 30 centimeter in thickness, and the above step is 20 centimeter in thickness. Okay, so the same thing is on the other side. Then after that, here you can see we have an inlet pipe. Okay, so this is your inlet pipe. Okay, inlet pipe, and then here is your outlet pipe. So this is your outlet pipe. The inlet pipe and outlet pipe, what is the diameter? So 100 mm and 300 centimeter in length, and this is 100 mm in dia. So this is your outlet pipe. Okay, so note one thing, that's all these dimensions, okay, all these dimensions, 15 30 140, these are all in centimeters, okay, not in mm. All of these are in centimeters. So keep that in mind while calculating the dimensions or noting down the dimensions. Next thing, we can observe there is one element over here. So this might seem that it is floating in air, but it is a baffle wall. It is called as a baffle wall. It runs from one short wall to other short wall. So in a plan, you will observe. So this is your baffle wall, which is running. Sorry, it is running from one long wall to long wall. Okay, and we have some amount of bearing over here and over here, so that it will be standing in place. So this is your baffle wall, which is 4 centimeter in thickness. A baffle wall, and then we have iron steps. You can observe we have iron steps which have been provided, which will allow us to get inside this particular soak pit, right? So you can observe. So we have one over here, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, 4 number of iron steps are provided over here. Okay, moving down, then you can observe here. This is your PCC bed or your CC bed. Sorry, it is your CC bed. Okay, 1:3:6 proportion. And then you have this sloped portion, okay, sloping portion over here, you can observe. So this thing we need to calculate separately, and this thing, the sloped portion, we will calculate separately. Okay, then after that, we need to calculate the plastering, which is required, right, plastering for these walls, and then cement plastering for this floor, okay. So we need to calculate all these dimensions and provide a particular estimate. Okay, so all these things are given. Let us look into the plan view so that it is clear. So this is a sectional view for your soak pit. Sorry, it is a sectional view of your septic tank. Okay, this is a septic tank and this is the plan view. Okay, this is your plan view. Here you can see this is your PCC bed. Okay, from top if you observe, you can observe this is PCC bed. And then you have this first step. Okay, this is your first step of your wall, first step. And then this is your second step of your wall. The rectangular sections you can see from the top. Then you have a baffle wall. This is your inlet pipe, right? And this is your outlet pipe. So in 2 inch distance they have given, so 200 by 90, okay, this is 290, both are in centimeters, okay, all of them are in centimeters. Then you can observe that the first step is 20 centimeter in thickness, first step is 20 centimeter in thickness, and the second step is 30 centimeter in thickness, second step, okay. Second step is 30 centimeter in thickness. Then the distance from your inside of your wall to your PCC bed, how much it is? It is 40 centimeters, okay, from the inside of your wall going up to PCC bed edge, okay, outside edge, so it is 40 centimeters. So the same dimensions are here also. This is 20 centimeter in thickness, then second step is 30 centimeter in thickness, and the distance from your inside of your wall going up to outside edge, okay, going up to outside edge of your bed, okay, bed concrete, it is 40 centimeter. Okay, it is same thing. In this direction and this direction, both dimensions are same. So keep that in mind. Even if they have not mentioned, you can observe. So it is same. Okay. Now, I hope this part is clear. I hope all the elements of your septic tank is clear. What all the elements are there, I have clearly mentioned. If you have any doubt, please let me know. If you didn't understand any of the part, please.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, your voice is too low, sir.
Voice is low.
Yes, sir.
Volume is low. Is it fine now? Please try to increase your volume in your mobile also, or your software in your system. Okay. So, okay. So, is this part clear? Is this longitudinal section and plan view clear? Just let me know whether it is clear. If you didn't understand any of the part, just let me know. I'll explain it once more. So this is a this is a septic tank. Okay, this is a septic tank. So this is from your house. Whatever the effluent is coming, it will come here. Then it will go to your soak pit. From here, it will go to your soak pit. Okay. So first, we will learn how to estimate this septic tank, and then we will learn how to estimate a soak pit, quantity of a soak pit. Now, starting with your estimate, the first thing we need to always calculate is your earthwork in excavation. Okay, earthwork in excavation, right? So in the plan view, in the section view, it will be clear. So this is your ground level, you can observe. This is your ground level. From here up to here, you need to excavate, right? From here to here, you need to excavate. What is that height? What is that height? It is 30, right? 30 plus 140 plus 20, right? 30 plus 140 plus 20 you need to do to get the depth. And what is the width that you need to excavate? So from here going up to here, right? So let us calculate what is that. So into in distance, they have given how much? It is 200. Into in distance is 200. Next, then this is how much? From here to here, it is 40, right? It is 40 centimeters. So 40 centimeters here and 40 centimeters here. So 200 plus 40 plus 40, it will be 280, right? 280 centimeters. Remember, it is centimeters. Then in this direction, from starting from here up to here, we need to excavate, right? So what is this dimension? It will be 90, which is into in 90 plus 40 plus this side also 40, right? So that is the distance from here going up to here for excavation, right? So that is what we will write now. So 2.8. which is the length, right? So this is 2.8, and then this is how much? 1.7, right? 90 plus 40 plus 40. Then depth we have calculated. I've shown you from where, starting from ground level going up to your bottom level. So this is for excavation. Next, for foundation bed, that is this, okay, CC bed, which we have provided. Okay, consider the rectangular part only. Okay, consider this rectangular part only. So the dimensions will be same, right? The length and the breadth will be same. The depth will only vary. Yeah, depth will only vary. So it is 20 centimeter in thickness. Okay, so write that. So you can observe here, 20 centimeter in thickness, rest all dimensions are same. Now for sloping portion, we'll calculate separately. That is this triangular portion, right? This triangular portion, we will calculate separately. Okay, so what we can do is length and breadth. We know length and breadth. We know length is 200 mm and the breadth is 90. Okay, not 200 mm. It is 200 centimeters and 90 centimeters. Okay, now what about the height? What about the thickness? So it is slope, right? So it is zero over here. Okay, zero over here, and it is 10 centimeter height over here. So what we can do is we can take average height. We will take so zero over here. So zero plus 10. Right, plus 10 centimeters divided by 2, because we are taking average height we will take. So it will be what? It will be 5 centimeters. Okay. So our length is 200, the breadth is 90 centimeters, and the height is 5 centimeters. We will take average because it is a slope. Okay. That is what we have done over here. So 200, 90, and 5 centimeters. Okay. So that is what we have written, and this will give you the total quantity. Okay, total quantity add from here going up to here. Okay, now moving on to next. After you calculate your earthwork and foundation bed concrete, then you have to calculate the roof covering which you have to provide for your your septic tank. Then what is the dimension? So it will be from your first step to your second step, right? It will, you have to cover from here, this entire thing you have to cover, right? Using your RCC roof cover, this thing. Okay, so the in plan, you can calculate the dimensions. It is 200, right? 200 plus this wall thickness, plus this wall thickness over here and over here. So wall thickness is 20. So it will be 200 plus 20 plus 20, right? So it will be 240 centimeters. And in this direction, it will be 90 plus 20, 110 plus 20 over here at 130. So 240 plus 240 into 120, and the thickness of your roof slab is how much? Thickness of your roof slab is 7.5 centimeters is the thickness. So dimensions you can observe, it is from starting from your first step, right? Dimensions, it is from your first step, not from your second step or from your PCC pad. It is at the top, right? So you have to consider dimensions up to here. So I've told you 200 plus this wall thickness over here, plus this wall thickness over here. And in the other direction also 90 plus 2 times wall thickness. And the wall and the RCC slab is of how much thickness? It is 7.5 centimeters in thickness. Right. So that is what we have written then. Next for baffle wall. Okay, for baffle wall. It will be what for baffle wall? I've shown you where is this baffle wall. This is your baffle wall, okay? Baffle wall. So it is 4 centimeter in thickness, okay, baffle wall, and the length you can calculate over here. Length you can calculate. It is 90, right? Into in is 90 centimeters plus some amount of bearing, okay? In this direction as well as this direction. Bearing you can calculate. Or you can assume certain bearing like 5 centimeters, 10 centimeters bearing. You can assume, and you can calculate the total length. Okay, 90 plus bearings. And what is the depth of your baffle wall? What is the depth? It is 30 centimeters plus 15 centimeters. So it is 45 centimeters in depth. Okay. So now we have calculated for baffle wall, right? Now we have calculated excavation. We have calculated the PCC bed, this sloping bed. Then we have calculated roof slab. We have calculated baffle wall. Now we have to calculate what? This walls, okay, walls on the either side. Walls we will calculate. So we'll divide what? We'll divide the walls into two steps. Okay, so the bottom step is first step, and the second step is this one at the top. Okay, so starting from bottom. So this is your first step, and this top one is your second step. So you can observe the thickness of this first step is how much? It is 30 centimeters, and the thickness of your second step is 20 centimeters. Height of your first step is 60 centimeters. Height of your second step, it will be what? You have to calculate. So it will be 140 plus 30, okay, 140 plus 30 minus 60. minus 60, that is this height, height of your first. Total height minus height of your first step will give you the height of your second step. Okay, from here to here. Okay, you need to calculate that. Okay. So now what we will do for calculation, we can use either centerline method, or we can go for your long wall short wall method. So in this problem, we will solve using long wall short wall method. Okay, long wall short wall method, we will solve this problem. So we will divide our steps into long walls and short walls. Okay, so it will be helpful if you do that in your plan view. So this we will consider as long wall, okay, long wall, because this is longer in length. So we will divide it. So observe, so this is my long wall starting from here and going up to here. So this is my long wall, entire thing is my long wall. Okay, so this is one long wall. Similarly, one long wall you have over here. So two number of long walls, okay, and two number of short walls. So this is what is left out over here, starting from here, going up to here. This is your short wall. So two short walls are also two in number. Okay, two number of short walls, two number of long walls. Now, this is what I've drawn is, this is for your second step, right? This is your second step. But your first step is what? First step is over here. So this is your first step, you can observe, which is 30 centimeter in thickness, right? So now we will calculate the length. We will calculate what the length we need to calculate for long walls, first step and second step, right? Two in number, because long wall and short wall are two in number. Each of them are two in number. Now we will calculate these length. Okay, we will calculate this length. So this is your long wall, right? This is your long wall in section. If you observe, the length of your long wall, length of your long wall will be from here going up to here. Okay, so this is for long wall, going from here, starting from this edge, ending up to here. So how much it is? So it is in-to-in distance is how much? This is 200. In-to-in distance is 200 plus this wall thickness over here, plus the wall thickness over here. So 200 plus 30. Plus 30, it will be 260 centimeters, 260 centimeters or 2.6 meters. That is starting from here, okay, starting from here, right, this is your long wall, starting from here, ending up to here. So it will be 260 centimeters or 2.6 meters. Okay, so this is for long wall number one, long wall number one, that is in your first step. Now moving on to long wall number two, long wall number two. So it will start from here and end up to here. Right, so 200, same thing, 200 plus this wall thickness, which is 20, and then this wall thickness, which is 20. So 200 plus 20 plus 20, it will be 240. Right, so 240 centimeters or 2.4 meters. Height I've told you, it is 60 for first step, and height you have to calculate here for your second step. That is 140 plus 30 minus 60. So we are done with long walls. So let me just show you. So this is what I've drawn in red now, what I've drawn in red over here. So this is your long wall number two. That is the long wall in second step. Long wall in second step. So what is the length of this? As I've shown you, so 200, which is in 200 plus this wall thickness, right? Plus this wall thickness over here and over this side. So it is how much? 2.4 meters. And the thickness, we know it is 20 centimeters. Okay. So I hope this long wall is clear. Long wall is clear. So right, you can observe over here, length 2.6 and 2.4. Thickness, you can directly write down. So first step is 30 centimeter in thickness. Second step is 20 centimeter in thickness. So height I have shown you. First step height was 60 centimeters. It was directly given. And the second step we have to calculate, right, from the total height. If you reduce first step height, you will get your height of your second step. Okay, now moving on to short wall. Moving on to short walls. So you can observe, so this is your short wall. Okay, this element is your short wall. Okay, so what is the height of your, what is the length of your short wall? 90 centimeter directly, right? 90 from here going up to here. So it is 90, length is 90, and the thickness of your first step is 30 centimeters, right? 90, same. Two number of walls, short walls in first step and second step. First step thickness is 30 centimeters. Second step thickness is 20 centimeters. So you can calculate the You can calculate the quantity of brickwork. Okay, total quantity of brickwork that is required is 2.77 cubic meters. Okay, so short wall calculation is easy. Long wall, what you need to do for long wall, you need to add the wall thicknesses. Okay, add the wall thicknesses, get the length. Okay, and for short wall, what is the in-to-in distance? That is it. Yeah, there no need to do any addition or subtraction. Okay, so same method which we have used in calculation of your residential buildings, right? Same method, long wall, short wall, we have used over here. So you can try the same using centerline method. You can try the same using centerline. You will get the same quantities, but it will be extra steps are required for your centerline, wherein you need to calculate the centerline first, right? You need to calculate centerline, and then you need to multiply that by the thickness and as well as your height. Okay. So instead of this thing here you will have the centerline lengths. Okay, if you use centerline method. Okay. So the main problem with centerline method, if you are trying this with a centerline method, is you need to calculate separately for each step. Centerline for each step. So suppose you are calculating centerline for this step. You have to calculate from, this is our center line, okay? So you have to calculate the distance from center line of this step going up to this step. Now, if you want to calculate for the second step, it will be different again. If you want to calculate for second step, you have to again find out the center line, right? So center line will be from here, right? It will be here. So you can observe it is not same for first step and second step. Your center lines are not same, right? Because of that, you need to calculate the centerline length separately for each step. Okay, so that is one extra step which is required if you try to solve using centerline. Okay, so long wall, short wall is better compared to your this method, right? Your centerline method, long wall, short wall terms to be easy, right? Only you need to add your thickness of your walls and you can calculate the length. Okay, a short wall is direct, no need for any calculation for a short wall. So after this, now what we are left out is your plastering work, like internal plastering for your walls, internal plastering for your walls and plastering for your flooring, right? So this thing needs to be plastered because there is this water and all coming inside. So your walls should be protected and there should be no leakage of your effluent water, right? So because of that, we need to plaster this inside surface of your septic tank. So what is the inside surface? Now we have to calculate the length of the inside surface. Similarly, as we have done for your brickwork calculation. So in-to-in distance we need in-to-in distance, right? So it is given 200. So this surface is 200 mm in length. This surface is also 200 mm in length, right? 200 mm, 200. Height is what? The entire thing. Height is entire thing, 140 plus 30. 140 plus 30, and the length we know, height we know. So you can calculate the surface area which needs to be plastered for your long walls, right? For your long walls. So now for short walls, this surface, right? This surface over here, and then second surface is over here. So 90 is the length of plastering, and what is the height? Same height, right? 140 plus 30. So you have calculated plastering for your long walls as well as short walls, okay? Long wall and short wall, we have calculated plastering. Next, for your flooring, it will be what? It will be in twin, right? So this part we need to plaster, right? This part we need to plaster for your flooring. So it will be what? 200 by 90, right? 200 by 90, that is it for your flooring plastering. So plastering is done, all of these things are done. Now, after plastering for long wall, short wall, and then for your flooring, we have done with this. Then some pipes are provided, right? Inlet pipe, then outlet pipe, right? Inlet pipe, outlet pipe, and then this vent pipe, which is provided, and then certain iron steps are provided. Okay, iron steps are provided. So that no need of any calculation for that. No need of any calculation. Just to write the numbers. Okay. So one number of inlet pipe, and then one number of what? Your ventilation pipe, one number of ventilation pipe, and four number of steps. Directly you have to write, no need of any calculation. Okay, So these quantities, no need of any calculation, just write the number and then you can represent this in abstract, okay, by multiplying the cost or the rate. So after this is done, we need to prepare an abstract of an estimate, abstract of our estimate, wherein you write whatever calculation you have done, right? Whatever particular item you write, the name, the quantity you write that you have calculated, then multiply that by the rate, okay, multiply that by the rate and write your total amount. Okay, excavation I've told you. Similarly, for all the items which you have calculated, you have to write the quantity that you have calculated, multiply that by the rate which is given in your question, and then calculate the total. Okay, so now this is your total amount, okay, total amount, which is addition of all of this, starting from your excavation, ending up to here. Now, every time what you need to do, you need to add 3% contingency and 2% of your work charged establishment amount, okay? So 3% and 2% of what? Of this amount, 3% and 2%, that is totally 5%. Okay, so you know, always you have to add 5% extra. Remember this step. So after adding, the total, grand total will be 9,834 rupees. So this is for one septic tank, the amount that you will, it will cost you to build a septic tank. It is 834 rupees. So this problem I have discussed in detail, so that from the next problem it will be easier for you to understand. So any doubt regarding any of the steps, please let me know. If any of the part is not clear, please let me know. Please let me know if you have any doubts in calculation of any of the things. If you want me to repeat any of the calculation, please let me know. So typical septic tank we have calculated. All the others will be similar. Okay, all the other septic tanks will also be similar. Certain elements will change, like this baffle wall might change. Then the dimensions will change, okay? And the number of steps might change. 3 steps, 2 steps. Then iron steps, and then certain elements will change, but the overall thing will be similar. Overall calculation will be similar. Okay, so is it clear, guys? Is it clear? Please let me know if I can move on to the next numerical. Yes or no? Is it clear? Am I audible? Yes, right? Please let me know whether this problem is clear. Okay. Yes, Aziz has understood. Others? Others? Have you guys understood? Yes. Okay. So very easy compared, if you are compared to a residential building. If you are perfect with the residential building calculation estimation, this part is very easy. You can finish within 10 minutes, right? Very easy, and nothing is complicated over here. So if you have practiced well for your first module, second module is very easy. Okay, so now what we'll do is your next two septic tank problems I will explain briefly. I will give you an overview, you can practice on later. Okay, in detail I will not explain this problem. I will give you an overview. So in this problem, we have been given with a septic tank. Septic tank, then we have to calculate all these 10 items. 10 items we have to calculate, starting from earthwork and going up to manhole cover. Okay. Then here, let me just show you this longitudinal section. So here, this is your longitudinal section. You can observe. So starting from top, you can observe that this is a RCC roof, RCC slab which is provided of 7.5 centimeter thickness. Okay. Then there is this manhole cover which is provided 45 centimeters in diameter. Okay. It is a circular manhole cover which is provided so that we can enter into this soak pit. For this septic tank. Okay. So after you enter, you can observe there are number of steps which are provided. Number of steps are provided. Iron footsteps. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7. seven number of footsteps are provided. Then you can observe there is inlet pipe, then there is outlet pipe which is provided. Okay, there is this vent pipe which is provided. Okay, all these things you have to note down later on. Then here also you can observe there is also here also one cover is provided, same thing which is provided, manhole cover 45 centimeter dia. Then steps, the side walls are in three steps, 1, 2, and 3. So 20 centimeter is the first step thickness, second step is 30 centimeter in thickness, third step is 40 centimeter in thickness. Okay, so that is clear. Height I have been provided over here, clearly heights have been provided. First step is 67.5 centimeter in thickness, sorry, in height, then 50 centimeter and 40 centimeter. Okay, no doubt in any of these things, directly they have been given. Then this partition type wall has been given in middle. Okay, partition wall. Okay, so here you can observe this is your wall, and then there is this gap which is provided. You can observe there is this gap. Okay, so take in consideration while calculation, this hole also you need to consider. So this wall is how much? So this wall is about 120 centimeter. So 120 centimeter plus 15 centimeter in height, 15 centimeter in height. And the thickness, let us see what is the thickness. Thickness of this is 10 centimeter. Okay, thickness of this wall is 10 centimeters. Okay. So this is your longitudinal section. Then this CC bed is given over here. You can observe CC bed is 15 centimeter in thickness. And the length, they have not provided us with the length. We will calculate the length. Okay. So this is our ground level. So the depth of excavation is from here going up to here. So this is the depth of our excavation. So you can just add. So it is 6.5, 67.5 plus 50 plus 40 plus 15. This entire thing will give you, addition of all these things will give you the depth of excavation. Here they have provided, look, they have provided us the length of our excavation, length of our excavation they have provided, but they have not provided us the breadth of our excavation. So this you need to calculate breadth of our excavation. So it will be what? So into in distance, let us check into in distance. So it is 3.7 meters by 0.9 meters. This is your into in distance of your septic tank. Then this is your first step, which is 20 centimeter in thickness, right? So this is 20 centimeter. Then second step is how much? 30 centimeter, right? Second step is 30. And then this third step is 40 centimeter in thickness. Then this PCC bed, right? A CC bed. So this is 10 mm offset. So sorry, 10 centimeters offset is given. Okay, 10 centimeter offset. So this is 10 centimeter from here to here is 10 centimeters. So now we can calculate the out-out distance. So this thing we can calculate. Also the same thing will be applied over here. So this is 20 centimeter. This is 20. And then this is 30. This is 40. And then this offset is 10. So the total distance from here to here is 50. Right, 50. So the out-out distance now we can calculate. It is 0.9. This 0.9 plus 50 centimeters over here. Plus 50 centimeters over here. So this is 50 and this is 50. So it will be what? It will be 1.9 meters, 1.9 meters over here. So this dimension is what? 1.9. So now we have got the dimensions of your excavation, which is 4.7 by 1.9 by the depth of your excavation. Multiply that by the depth of your excavation. So similarly for the CC bed, it will be similar, but only thing is the depth will vary, right? The thickness you have to mention as 15 centimeters. So we are done with that. Next thing you have to calculate is your RCC roof cover. RCC roof cover. RCC roof cover you can consider from here. Okay, you can consider from here, or else you can consider in to in, and then certain amount of bearing you can consider. Okay, so what we'll do is we will consider in to in plus half of this wall thickness as bearing. Half of this wall thickness as bearing we will consider. So in to in is 3.7 plus 10 centimeters over here as bearing and 10 centimeters over here as bearing for your roof slab. Similarly over here it will be 90 plus bearing over here and half of the wall thickness as bearing over here. thickness is given as 7.5 centimeters for your RCC roof slab. So no problem in RCC roof slab calculation. Next. Next, what we can calculate? Next, we can calculate your brickwork, right? Brickwork using long wall, short wall method. You can calculate for first step, then for second step, and for third step. Calculate those things. Then you can calculate for this partition wall in between. Partition wall in between you can calculate after that. So after that is over, we can calculate your plastering work, right? Plastering work, which is provided for your internal plastering for your walls, okay, for your walls, this side, for your long walls, as well as short walls. And then plastering should also be provided. Plastering should also be provided for your this partition wall, okay? So this surface you need to plaster, this surface you need to plaster, right? And this surface also you need to plaster. So you need to add all these surfaces for your plastering work along with your plastering for your long wall, short wall. You need to consider plastering for this wall also. Okay, so dimensions are given. Dimensions are given. So this is 1.2, right? Plus 15, plus 15. And the thickness is 10 centimeters, right? Thickness is 10 centimeters. So I hope the calculation is easy, right? Surface area calculation is very easy. Then you need to consider number of steps, 7 number of steps you need to write. Then 1 number of inlet pipe, 1 number of outlet pipe, 1 number of vent pipe. Okay, so with this, I think this manhole will be done, right? Let us just look into the calculation part. Right, so earthwork in excavation, I have told you how to calculate, right? Out-to-out distance, then foundation in foundation concrete in base, right? Same, but only the depth will vary, right? Only the depth will vary. Then you need to calculate all the long walls and short wall, right? You need to calculate brick masonry work. So you can see that they have divided it into 3 steps: first step, second step, third step. Similarly for short walls. Okay, so after this, one partition wall, right? I've told you one partition wall is there. So one number of partition wall, then length of that partition wall is 0.9 meters. Let us just look into what is the length. So what they have taken is this length, right? Well, this is your partition wall over here. This is your partition wall. So no need to consider any bearing for this. No need to consider any bearing, right? So 0.9 is this length. And what is the thickness? Thickness is 10 centimeters. And the height of this partition wall is 1.2 plus 15 centimeters. So partition wall is clear. Next. Partition wall is done. Next. We need to calculate roof slab cover. I've told you, assume 10 centimeter bearing, assume. And then you can calculate this bearing. So one number of roof slab. This is your length. And then this is your breadth. And the thickness of a roof slab is what? 7.5 centimeters. 7.5 centimeters is 0.075 meters. Okay, so this is very easy. No need for any calculation. Directly you can write down. Then after this, what I have told you, we have to plaster your internal surface, right? Interior surface plastering for long walls, for short walls, and then for partition wall. Partition wall both sides, right? Partition wall this side, partition wall this side, both surfaces, as well as your top surface, right? Top surface. So you need to consider these two things extra along with your long wall and short wall. So after that, CC flooring, right? CC flooring. So what we will do is we'll take 5 centimeter average thickness. We will take 5 centimeter average thickness. So you can observe here. So you can observe. So this is a slope, right? This is slope. 1 in 4 slope is given. So you can calculate the height starting from here going up to here. So it will happen? It will come up to 10 centimeters, I think. So you need to take average like 0 plus this side height, right? This side height, that is 10 centimeters divided by 2. So it will be 5 centimeters, right? So that we will consider for your flooring. We will take average 5 centimeters of thickness, and then we will calculate your CC flooring. As I've told you, this inlet and outlet pipe, right? And then one number of vent pipe, okay, vent pipe. And then one number of this top cowl, which we need to provide for your vent pipe. And then two number of manhole covers, right? Two number of manhole covers. And then one thing they have missed is this seven number of steps, iron steps they have missed. So you can add that also. Okay. So similarly, as we have done in the previous problem, this is also same, but the dimensions are different, a bit different. That is it. So I think this is clear. I hope this is clear. So you can try to practice this problem, okay, in your notebook. And if you have any doubts, you can let me know. So that the first numerical was for a septic tank of a smaller dimension, but this is a bigger dimension septic tank. Yeah, so you have two manhole covers, you can observe here. So this is one cover over here, and then this is your second cover. So why have they provided two covers? Because there is a partition wall in between, right? There is a partition wall in between. So we have provided two number of manhole covers. Okay, so inlet pipe, outlet pipe, two number of manhole covers. Then you can observe steps, right? Steps are provided. These are the steps which have been provided. Then is this numerical clear? If you want me to explain any of the parts, just let me know. Any of the calculation, if you want me to explain, I will show you the calculation in detail. So if this is clear, we will move on to the next problem. If this is clear, we will move on to the next problem. Is it clear, guys? Is this numerical? So I've just given you an overview. I have not solved it in detail. You can try to solve it in your notebook. And if you face any problems, you are free to ask me anything. Okay, so this is regarding a septic tank. So one more septic tank we have. This is a unique one wherein we have a septic tank. So this is our septic tank, and as I've told you, your effluent which goes out from a septic tank goes to your soak pit. Okay, it goes to your soak pit. So we have a soak pit along with our septic tank. So in this third numerical, we will calculate along with our septic tank for a soak pit also. Okay, so this is our soak pit, wherein your whatever the liquid or the water is coming over here, it is allowed to soak in our ground, right? As the name suggests, it is a soak pit, wherein the water is allowed to percolate into your surrounding soil, right? So this is your soak pit. So this is our plan view, you can observe. So this is your septic tank with one partition wall over here, right? You can observe over here, one partition wall is there. And then there is one pipe, outlet pipe, which is going and connecting to your soak pit, right? So I'll just give you an overview of this thing, and we will solve this in your next class. Okay, I'll just give you an overview, and in detail we will solve in next class. Just only five quantities they have asked us to calculate. Okay, only five quantities: earthwork in excavation, foundation bed concrete, first class brickwork, RCC roof slab cover, and plastering. Okay, plastering with waterproof compound. So only five quantities we need to calculate in your septic tank. Okay. So let me explain the parts of your septic tank. Starting from your top, it has 8 cm thick RCC slab, 8 cm thick RCC slab. Okay, and then this RCC slab is supported on your wall, right? Wall. So this wall is 30 centimeter in thickness. Then second step, it is 40 centimeter in thickness. Third step is 50 centimeter in thickness. So below you have a CC bed. Below you have a CC bed of 40 centimeter thickness. Okay, 40 centimeter thickness. Various heights of your different steps are given over here. Then you have a partition type of wall over which here, which is provided. Okay, partition wall, which is 1.5 meter in height. Okay, 1.5 meter in height, and then thickness, it will be given in your plan. So your thickness is 20 centimeters. Okay, thickness of your partition wall is 20 centimeter. Next, so steps are provided. You can observe here, a manhole cover is provided, and below that manhole cover, steps have been provided so that you can come inside this septic tank for any maintenance work. Okay, four number of steps you can observe, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four number of iron steps are provided. Then Length of this septic tank is given 8.4. Length of the septic tank is given 8.4. And the width of the septic tank is given as 2.6 meters, 2.6. Okay. But this breadth, I think it is only for our first step. Okay. It is only for our first step. Right. It is from here. Okay. It is from first step. It is not from your PCC bed. So we need to calculate that. Okay. So keep in mind. So this plan is only for your first step. So this plan shows only first step from a top view. So besides this, there is your second step. Then besides that, you have your third step, and then you have your PCC, right? PCC. So we need to calculate from here going up to PCC bed edge. Right? So this is your total breadth of your septic tank. So length is directly given, but this breadth we need to calculate. So excavation will be easy once you have that. Then PCC bed concrete you can calculate. Then this steps, right? Brickwork in steps you have to calculate. After that, you have to calculate plastering work. Plastering work, if you have calculated plastering work, most of our work is done. Then moving on to soak pit. Soak pit, you can observe here, this is a soak pit. So it is having circular cross section. It is having a circular cross section. It has a 8 cm thick RCC roof slab, right? RCC slab at the top. Then depth of the excavation here, you can observe it is 4 meters, okay, 4 meters. Then this walls have been provided, okay, 30 centimeter walls with open joints, okay, with open joints. So the joints are not plastered, they are open joints so that water can percolate into your soil. Okay, so walls are provided at both the sides, only one wall is there, okay. And then the diameter outdoor diameter is 3.6 meters. So in-to-in diameter is 3 meters and then outdoor diameter is, right, 3.6 meters. Right. And then you can observe in plan, it is a circular cross section. This is our wall of 30 centimeters, wall of 30 centimeters. So soak pit calculation is very easy. You need to calculate excavation, right? Excavation quantity you need to calculate. Then you need to calculate this brickwork calculation you have to do, and then roof slab calculation. Okay. And with that, it will be done. Okay. So inside you can observe brick bats have been provided. We will look into how to calculate these brick bats in our next class. Okay, so this is just an overview of your soak pit along with your septic tank. So this is your septic tank, which is provided along with a soak pit. Okay, so the calculation in detail for this we will look into in your next class. Okay, so after we are done with this, okay, let me just show you what all we need to cover. So once we cover this, we need to move on with your next thing, that is your manhole, right? Manhole calculation. Similarly, as you have your soak pit, a similar type of structure will be provided. Which is called as a manhole, right? So that we need to calculate all those quantities in our manhole. Similarly, as we have calculated in septic tank. So similarly, we will calculate quantities in manhole. And after we are done with this, we have to calculate we have to learn how to estimate our road quantities, right? Suppose this is our embankment of a road, right, which is running like this. So we need to learn how to calculate the quantities in this embankment. Okay, road work calculation we need to understand. So road, then so this wearing coat which is provided, that we need to calculate. Then if this embankment is divided into a base course, sub base course, right, all those things, if they are given separately, that quantities we need to calculate. And then a total volume we need to calculate, right? Volume we need to calculate, and we need to provide an estimate. Okay, so we are left out with this. So if you finish soak pit and all in the next class, so after that we will continue with your manhole calculations. Okay, so I hope this was easy, right? Very easy considering other module one problems. So these second module is very easy compared to that. So if you have any doubts, please let me know, and also you can start typing in your attendance. Okay, if you have any doubt in long wall, short wall, please go through that previous videos, right? Previous videos in your module one, so that you have a clear idea what is long wall, short wall. So for those who have not understood or who have not attended the previous module. So please go through those previous videos so that you have an idea of long wall, short wall. Okay. So everyone, please type in your attendance quickly. So next class is on Monday, wherein we have a 2-hour class. So first hour we will cover the septic tank. In a half an hour, I think we can cover the septic tank, and then rest of the time we will try to finish up with your manhole. Okay, manhole problems. I think 3 problems we have to solve in manhole, and Monday we will finish up with that, and we will move on to road estimation. Okay, so I think everyone has typed in their attendance. So if you have any doubt, if you want me to explain anything, you please, we still have time.